A few weeks ago, we learned that California lawmakers are moving forward with a Medicare for All bill, and now this week, we got some more good news. So the New York State Assembly voted to advance a Medicare for All bill themselves. Common Dreams explains, the New York Health Act would afford all state residents access to comprehensive inpatient and outpatient care, primary and preventative care, prescription drugs, behavioral health services, laboratory testing, and rehabilitative care, as well as dental, vision, and hearing coverage. There would be no premiums, deductibles, or copays. The plan would be funded through progressively raised taxes, including a surcharge that would be split 80-20 between employers and employees. With the fate of the bill now resting with the Senate, proponents like Citizen Action of New York Board President Yvette Alfonso on Tuesday urged state senators to prove once and for all they are with the people and against President Donald Trump. We are at a critical juncture as Washington considers new laws that would further entrench the insurance business, setting back patient access to quality, affordable care, added Jill Ferrillo, a registered nurse and executive director of the New York State Nurses Association, which lobbied for the bill. But with this vote, the Assembly recognizes that New York is ready to move forward, not backwards, and put in place a system that makes patient need the priority and says no to health insurance gatekeepers, she said. We salute the Assembly and urge the Senate to do the same. So this is fantastic news. I can't even tell you how exciting this is because, as I stated before, when we see states experimenting with certain policies, if, you know, California and New York chooses to be leaders with Medicare for All, what we often see is the domino effect. So even though it's just in California or just in New York, well, maybe a few years later, Oregon passes it, and then Colorado passes it. This is exactly what happened recently with marijuana. So once Colorado and Washington voted to legalize recreational marijuana, 2 years later, Oregon and Alaska did, and then 2 years later, we had California and Maine and other states. So this is how you get the ball rolling. So we all have a vested interest in these bills in New York and California, even if we don't reside in those states, because what happens in one state may spill over into other states, and that's exactly what we need. We need one state, just one, to do a Medicare for All system, get it right, and show everyone else in the country that it can be done. Because once one of these two states show that it can be done and that it's possible, then there's absolutely no excuse. We're not getting what our neighbors to the north in Canada are getting. We're getting mistreated. We're getting ripped off by the health insurance industry, namely because our elected officials in Congress are being bankrolled by the health insurance industry. So if one of these states can get this done and get it done right, then this will be fantastic. And this bill might even be more progressive than Canada's single-payer system, because I don't honestly know if Canada covers dental with their single-payer system. And, you know, certainly if you have universal healthcare coverage in countries like the UK and France, not all of them cover dental or vision. You get the whole nine yards. This is the real deal. Wow, this is fantastic. So look, we all know what we got to do now, right? You know, if you've been watching the Humanist Report, you know that grassroots activism is the way that we get these bills codified into law. So if you live in New York, you've got to call your state representative, your state senator, and let them know that you want them to support this bill. And also, for those of us who are outside of New York, we can call Governor Andrew Cuomo's office at 518-474-8390 and urge him to sign this bill into law and to endorse it publicly, because that could do a lot. I mean, you can get so much momentum for this bill just with that. So this is fantastic news, and I am incredibly excited about it. And you should be too, because it shows that the momentum and the pressure that we're putting on our elected officials, it's paying off. They're paying attention. We're crying out for Medicare for All, and certain states are starting to listen. We just got to keep at it.
Support this podcast by joining the independent progressive media revolution today at humanistreport.com.